I don't know how I made it here.
I don't know how I made it here.
But I know it's by the grace of God.
I know it's by the grace of God.
I don't know how I made it here.
I don't know how I made it here.
But I know it was by the grace of God.
I know it's by the grace of God.
I don't know how I made it here.
I don't know how I made it here.
But I know it was by the grace of.
Hello, my name is Ndifela Michelle Mankoto. I'm the principal of Inkululeko Isizwe Primary and the Triple D champion for 2017, the month of May. So I want to share with you what Triple D is all about. First, I will start by showing you how our country is doing when it comes to the use of Triple D. I will give you the statistics of the four different provinces that are doing well when it comes to the use of the Triple D. First, I will start with the Eastern Cape. We have 9 million learners record that are on the dashboard presently, and that represents about 70% of all the learners that we have in the entire country. So with Eastern Cape, they are having 1.8 million learners whose records are on the dashboard presently. And that makes 95% of all the schools that they have in the Eastern Cape. That is pretty good. And then we've got Gauteng, that is having 1.7 million learners record on the dashboard. And that makes 63% of all the schools in the entire province. And then the Limpopo province, it is having 1.6 million learners that are on whose record are on the dashboard presently, and that makes 91% of all the schools in the province. And then lastly, we've got KwaZulu-Natal, that is having 1.3 million of learners record in the dashboard, and that makes 89% of all the schools that they have in the dashboard. Now, the active users that we are having. Presently, for quarter two, we were standing at 4,869 users. That is not much. It means that we still have a lot of other users out there who still are supposed to be in the system. Let me share with you what the dashboard is up to presently. Presently, they are working on an interactive metric dashboard, focusing on all metric results at learners and subject level. That is very interesting. So if users are on the dashboard and all principals are on the dashboard, it means that we'll be able to interact with each other and help those learners who are not doing well, so that we can give each other information on what we are supposed to do. That is very interesting. An interactive dashboard, it means that it will always be active and it needs users. So if we're still having 4,000 and Kapla people who are on dashboard, it means that we are not having a lot of users. So the interactive dashboard is for us and it will benefit us. It will improve metric results, and that is very important. So please guys, let us be on a dashboard and help our children in the school. And learners at risk report, identifying learners who need support. Remember that we always have learners at risk. Those learners at risk, we are now gonna have a report that is a separate report on learners at risk, so that we can be able to know those learners and then we can be able to assist those learners as well. We have an increased focus on curriculum requirements to increase impact on learners' outcomes. Remember that the dashboard is curriculum compliant. So they have to increase that so that even other things that the dashboard is not doing presently, we can be able to do that. So it requires us to can be there so that we can give feedback on the use of the dashboard and some of the things that they have to face in and some of the things maybe that are not working for us that we can fix out. We have focused on specific provincial and district intervention using the dashboard to monitor and evaluate progress and impact. Isn't it that interesting? If we are having a focus on different provinces, on different districts, that means that we will definitely get intervention coming to us quite quick. And that is when we are using the dashboard. We are exporting our information to the dashboard. We will have an additional functionality on progress and retained learners. Remember that there are those learners who didn't do well in grade 11, who are progressing metric right now. Those learners require support. So if we have this record that we supported and they can be able to do well in the next grade. Then the one thing that I want to share with the entire country is that there is this quote that I wrote from Miriam Williamson. I just want to share this with all of you to say, our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate, but our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. And most of the time, we underestimate ourselves. And I can tell you right now that you are very much amazing. It is always said that curiosity killed the cat. But don't worry about that, because you are not going to be killed because you are not a cat. So you can be curious enough to work on what I'm showing you right now, and trust me, you are going to be the best you can ever be. Let me have our school breakdown when it comes to the use of the SASMS dashboard. Because remember that we cannot talk about dashboard without talking about SASMS. Because the information that is on SASMS is the one that we export to the dashboard so that we can be able to get all those reports. So, as usual, when we were trained, the principal will be trained with the administrators. And the most important thing will be when we come back, we have to monitor the administrators doing the job. But the fact of the matter is that the curriculum module, which is module 12 in SASMS, is meant for teachers and it is never meant for administrators. And if you are leaving that curriculum module to be the load of the administrators, then you have a lot of problems, and I will show you as we go on. Then what happens is that as a school, we were also using administrators, and there are a lot of challenges that we faced until I had to sit down and then ensure that that module is moved, and there's a lot that I did so that I can safely conclude to say the module is never meant for administrators. So what I did, I had to put together a calculation. That calculation is actually talking about my school enrollment. And as a primary school, I am having foundation phase, intermediate phase, and senior phase is only one class. So this is what I did. We are having 561 learners here. That's another foundation phase. And then I have four subjects in the phase. So what I did, I would multiply this number by this number, then it's going to give me this one. And I did the same with this one, which is giving me this total, and then I did the same with that one and giving me this total. So what then happened is that we've got comments per subject and also general comment, hence the 5 here. And then the same applies to this, the same applies to that. And because of that, I have to multiply this number by the comments per subject and general comment. And together with this one and that one, this is the total that I got. And when I get this total, I have to add them together. When I add them together, this is the number that that I got. It's 15,365. Then if I divide this number by 3, then I'm going to get 16,788.3. So meaning that my administrators are overloaded. If they are going to enter about 16,788 times, so it means they are overloaded. Then when I divide this number by the number of teachers that I have, then I get 1,573.9. Meaning that then the load is going to be lighter here. Then it was never all, because you remember that when you assign a wrong responsibility to wrong people, it's either you will fight with their unions or you will fight with them. So you won't have peace when it comes to the implementation process. And I did not want that. So what I did, I had to go to the PEM document. You remember that PEM document has got a lot of things that are revised presently. And then there is this a job description of educators. And it is saying that the teacher has to teach, assess, record, and report. So meaning that recording is SASMS only and nothing else. It means that recording has to be electronically and never manual. So it means they are safe. Then the other thing that I want to share with you here is that when you go to the curriculum module, you will find that each and every item in that module, the sub-modules that are there, you will find that they are curriculum related, even the terminologies as well. Then what we did as a school, after I safely concluded that the module really is for educators, then what I did is that I had to connect the four standing computers in my school. And then those four standing computers, they are for educators to use. Yeah. They are for educators to use. So now, the four, it means that the... So the four standing computers that we're having, they look like this. So teachers will be able to come and sit with the computer and then work, and then when they finish, they leave. But I have a lot of problems because I have three faces here. So, and then I then we concluded to buy laptops for each and every educator, because even the 10 laptops were not working. Then the 10 the laptops for teachers, then they started working well, because then we had to connect them, and then teachers were able to work at even their own free time. And then at the time when I was supposed to say well done, because then when we started using this thing, that was when we were able to complete our job on time, we were able to submit to the district on time as well, and because of that, I was finding joy in all that we were doing, and because of that, then I had to say well done to my teachers. And at the time when I was supposed to do that, unfortunately, the MEC had called us to come and collect our templates, so I was not there. So I had to organize a cartoon for them. This is the cartoon that is depicting the time when we started until the time when they would sit on their own and say, this is really good. We have to continue the way we are doing, because it's really good and it's making us to finish on time, and it's also helping us to learn even more. So this is the cartoon that I put together for them with my administrators. And then they pasted it all over the school so that the teachers can be able to view it, and they were happy with the message that was there. And then I just wanted to show you how we are doing as a school right now, when every teacher has got a laptop. This is really beautiful. So everybody has got a laptop and they are skilled as well. The e-learning unit and the Department of Education Johannesburg South, they were able to train them. And then Saibono also took over to give them a lot of skills when it comes to e-learning. And all these things came because we took the use of the dashboard very, very seriously. Then let me share with you now the purpose of the use of the purpose of the introduction of the dashboard. Remember the dashboard when it was introduced, there has to be a purpose behind it. And the purpose was to ensure the use of facts and data to inform decision making. Because as principals, always when we make decisions, we need to consider facts that are on the table, we need to consider the data that is available. And when we have all those things in place, we are then able to make decisions. The benefits that you will enjoy if you are on dashboard are the following. The dashboard will allow schools to use assessment data to identify focus areas that require attention and support so that all the learners at risk, the poor subject. Then with subject performance, it enables leaders to allocate subjects correctly based on strength. Remember that the dashboard will give you all the record when it comes to how the subjects are doing. And then with this record, you are able to see poor performances in different subjects. You are also able to see good performances. And with this information, you are able to allocate well to teachers. You are also able to develop teachers well, because you will be able to see the weaknesses as well. And then school leadership can use learner performance data in conjunction with teacher attendance to make proper decisions with regard to performance management for teachers. Then here, you know that attendance of teachers, it impacts a lot on learners' performance. So it means that the learner performance report and teacher attendance report, if you can go through the poor attendance of educators and see the child subject that the teachers are teaching, sometimes you will find that the absenteeism of the teachers are impacting on learners' performance. You should not forget that an educator's privilege as they are to be absent from work when they are sick, when somebody passed away in the family, but it doesn't have to impact on the child's right to learn. So at the end of the day, we have to do something. Some schools are privileged to have assistant teachers, some are not. And those that are not privileged to have assistant teachers, you need to do something so that the lost time, we have to make up for it. And the printed dashboard reports, they can be reused in response to departmental queries. You know that we always have stats required on this and that, and most of the time when they require such information, it is already available on the dashboard. So you just take that information and reuse it. It increases the school accountability and the way we work, because at the end of the day, when you see all those weaknesses in your school, you cannot just sit and never do anything about it. And then, on the dashboard online this time, then you will be able to see that when we log into the dashboard, remember that the dashboard is a login credential, and then you have to put in your login credential there. That is my name, and that is the password, and then you log in there. And then when you log in there, then it will give you the dashboard user interface. And the interface will quickly project the school summary. The school summary is having five pie charts. The first one is learner attendance, educators attendance, the task coverage, and the previous year's results, and the term results. This is the completeness of your data. So it means that if you do not complete your data here and there, then your pie chart is not going to appear the way you see it here. It will appear somehow with an exclamation mark, somehow red, somehow yellow. That means that you did not do something well there. So that is your dashboard. And then you go to the reports there. When it will give you a drop-down menu, this drop-down menu is going to give you a lot of reports that you have there. And most of the reports that you have, most of them will be highlighted. The highlighted ones are the ones that you can be able to download. And the ones that are not highlighted means there is no information there. So all that are highlighted there, you click on it, you will be able to see that there is an information there. And then save it and then go through it at your own spare time so that you can be able to see what is there. It will assist you in the management of your school. And then I want to share with you the problem that we have. Our school is actually situated in the informal settlement of Vlakfontein, south of Johannesburg. So most of the time we have a lot of challenges in informal settlement. I want to show you my term one learners, list of learners without ID numbers. Remember when you went with the essay sense, it will give you an option to put an ID number. If the parent is still applying, it will give you that option as well. So for all those parents who are still applying, the dashboard will then list all those learners whose IDs are not available because their parents are still applying. And that information, that is the information that you have to use. Then judging at the numbers. In my school, I've got 1,376 learners. And then the learners without IDs, I've got 620. I was adding 629 in term one. That shows that in the area, we've got problems when it comes to IDs. Parents as well don't have they don't have IDs, and learners don't have ID numbers as well because they can't apply for their children's birth certificate because of that. And then the dashboard enables you to have this list of learners who do not have ID numbers so that you can keep reminding your parents to say they have to apply because such information is required. Then we on term two, when we're trying to decrease the number, then we manage to. Right, term two then, after working with the administrators to try and reduce the number, then we sent the information to the parents, and then we only managed to reduce by 76, and that makes it the total of learners without ID numbers to be 551. So that is not much, it is actually showing that we've got a problem in the area. This is the problem that most of the people don't actually know about, because they are not on dashboard. So once you are on the dashboard, that list of learners without ID numbers will be there, and then you can be able to work on that list so that you reduce the number of learners without ID numbers. Remember that they will also be excluded to write the matric exam if they don't have IDs. So we need to handle such kind of a problem from primary so that when they go to high school, such problem is sorted. Let me show you the impact of exam added with report pass mark and how it looks like when an exam is now separated from the report mark. So here I'm going to show you, this is my exam test. This is the report mark. It means that the SBA, the exam, all is added together. And then if you can check the number of learners that I have there, the highlighted area is the 433 area according to the curriculum policy. You remember that 4 home language, 3 farm, and then. But let's go to the exam test. Where now learners. Right, so I want to show you how learners perform differently with exam and test, report pass mark, SBA, all those things. So that you can be able to see that sometimes when you look at the report mark of a child, there's still a lot that you still need to look at. you are having when economics is 4 of 104 and then 18 of 104. And then all those numbers going down. It's beginning to tell you that children are passing SBA a lot more than they do when they write tests and exam. So there are quite a number of things that we need to do as school principal and curriculum managers. Because you must know that the standard that you use to set your test should be the same standard that you use to set your SBA. So that the variance there should not be a very big gap. It should be a gap that is acceptable. So let's talk about the challenges that we are facing when we have to be on dashboard and face exams. The challenges that we are having here, we still having internet connectivity being a serious challenge that we are experiencing, especially in an informal settlement schools and schools that are in rural areas. We still have a challenge with internet connectivity. And then we also have a lack of monitoring. Sometimes when you have officials who are supposed to come and monitor the implementation of SSMs, that is not happening. So that is why some of the schools are also not on SSMs, not on dashboard as well, because there is poor monitoring. And then we've got selective use of module in the SSM program. That delays the users to be on dashboard. Because remember, you have to have your data completeness there. So if your data is not complete, then you are only selecting the curriculum module to be the one that you have to use. And then the information of learners, that is the learner listing. And then you are not looking into capturing the absenteeism of teachers and learners. That will delay you from being on a dashboard. So you need to ensure that you are using all the modules in the SSN so that when you export your information to the dashboard, you know that everything is in order. And then when you have to leave your SSNs and the dashboard to selective users, then you also have a problem of overload. You will overload some other personnel because they will have to do a lot of the work that is supposed to be done by other people. So users, we need to allocate the curriculum module to teachers so that at the end of the day, the job becomes lesser for the administrators. And then we also have poor perception of computer illiteracy. Most of the time when you have to introduce computers to teachers, you will be told that they are computer illiterate. But you are not forgetting that all of us have smartphones. When we have smartphones, it means that we are computer literate. And if you can start introducing the use of computers to your teachers, you will be able to see what I'm talking about. And you won't know unless you try. And then you've got data capturing. If you leave it to the administrators, you will always submit it. So that is another problem. And then remember that I indicated that our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate, but our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. And you will see it when you start introducing teachers as users. And then when you do that, they can actually delete your entire school database. So here you've got to be very proactive when you are assigning modules to teachers. You are assigning modules to SMT members. You are assigning modules to administrators. So that teachers can only access what is important to them, because then if you give them even some other things that belongs to other teachers, they will be able to view, they will be able to delete everything. So when you assign, then you are gonna avoid the deletion of information. And another thing is to have a backup so that you can backup your information if using an external hard drive. Also a cloud. You should create a cloud account so that you are able to download and stash your information in the cloud, and that will be good for you, because whenever your users are deleting the database, then you will know that your information is safe. I want to share with you the challenges that was in content one, so that you can be able to see that when you are on the dashboard, the information, your school information is on the palm of your hand. That is very amazing. Term 1 was having 82 learners of 105 in the foundation phase grade R with Faith language. After the intervention and support that I had given them, because I had to give them support here because this was really serious. Then in term 2, all the learners in grade R, they passed because of the intervention that I had given to them. And then I was also having 60 learners of 530 in the intermediate phase with Faith and Tech exam. Focus was on exempting. And then term 2, we only having 26 learners who failed LSA. And then I was also having from one source. So meaning that we won't differ with anything because the source of our information is one, which we have one information. Weaknesses and strengths of all schools will be visible to them, as well as the province as well as national. It means that support top-down will be quite big. And strength of other schools will be utilized to develop the weaknesses of other schools. And then the awards giving will be very much easier because all the subjects that are doing well, they are highlighted on the Google report. And then all the learners who are doing well, they are also highlighted there. And all the classes that are doing well are also highlighted there. So giving awards is going to be very easy because you will know who to give that award to. And solution on learners without ID will be quite easy because right now, SSM is working and networking with other departments like Home Affairs and all that, so that the problems that we have can easily be solved. So when you are on dashboard and SSM, you know that all that information that you are giving, that is a challenge to you, they will be easily identified because you are using this tool quite well, and then you will have support that you need. The subject performance state as well, they can be easily accessible at the district level. So meaning that the same as in the support, they can be able to give you support because they know how you're doing as a student. And then I want to believe that I'll be failing honestly if I don't give the dashboard people a gratitude, because we are what we are in this group because of the support that we got from Helen Tukosi and Jerry from Youth Leader Foundation. When you call them, when you have problems, they will definitely help you. And I also got a lot of support from our district, from TVLS, Yasala, Nkenke, as well as Lugelo, who's our IT engineer in the school. So thank you very much to those people. And also the platform that I received from the curriculum unit Johannesburg South, so that I can work with them on the dashboard and they are able to see how good this thing is. And I have to thank those people for what they have done to assist me so that I can be on board. And right now I enjoy life because I love coming to work and I love doing what I'm doing. And I don't struggle with anything because I have all the information. And my confidence is very much boosted this time around because I know that I'm school principal. Whatever that is happening around my school, I know everything. At a click of a button, I have all the information for all the learners that I have, the teachers, the performances, and the challenges I have. And I don't sit only. When I come to work, I have a lineup of what I'm supposed to do. And all because of SSS and dashboard. And thanks to the Youth Leader Foundation for bringing us on board. You can also be on board as well. So we are waiting for you. Come on board and we'll be able to assist. In case maybe you would want me to assist you, I indicated to you that my name is Nikilani Mampot. And my number phone is 082-553-2798. Those numbers are available in case you want me to assist you. You can call me. I can also come to you if you are around Jumbe, so that I can assist you to be on board, because it's very amazing. Trust me on that one. If it is not working for you, you've got me to blame. My numbers are there and my telephone numbers are there, so that you can tell me that it's not working like I'm telling you. But trust me, super stuff. Thank you.